Hello, this is Dr. Jack Jackson. In this video, we will use the formula we derived in the previous lecture to find the minimum sample size needed to compute a confidence interval for the mean of a population, where we are given the population standard deviation, a confidence level, and a margin of error. After you're studying this material, you should be able to work problems of this type, including homework set 5.1, problem number 5. Recall from our earlier work that we can find any one of the confidence level, the margin of error, or the sample size if we know the other two. Here is the same formula solved for each of the three variables, given in TI-84 notation. Note that 1 minus alpha over 2 is 1 plus the confidence level over 2. Next, let's put the last formula to work to find the needed sample size if we know the desired confidence level and margin of error. In the previous section and corresponding video, we derived the following formula, which gives a relationship among the margin of error, confidence level, and sample size with the formula solved for the sample size. If we establish a desired level of significance and acceptable margin of error, we can substitute these values into the formula to solve for the minimum needed sample size. Remember that we must always round the value of n up to the next largest whole number, not round off. For example, if we get 15.2, we will round up to 16. For example, suppose as in the previous videos, we're wanting to find a confidence interval for the mean weight of a group of people. Let's suppose this time that we want to be 99% confident that our interval will actually capture the true population mean weight. Furthermore, we want our confidence interval estimate to have an error of at most 2 pounds. So, we want to be 99% confident that we are approximating the population mean to within 2 pounds. Suppose that we know that the population standard deviation is 3 pounds. What is the minimum sample size we must take to make sure that we meet these criteria? Note that we need to find the z-score such that the probability to the left is 1 minus alpha divided by 2. Notice that this probability is calculated here two ways. First, we are given the confidence level is 1 minus alpha equals 0.99, which is a probability centered on the mean. This leaves the remaining probability of alpha equals 1 minus 0.99 equals 0.01, which is distributed evenly in the two tails with alpha over 2 equals 0.01 divided by 2 equals 0.005 in each of the two tails because of the symmetry of the normal distribution. So the desired z-score will have a probability of 1 minus alpha over 2 equals 1 minus 0.005 equals 0.995 to the left of it. An easier way to calculate this is to use the formula 1 plus the confidence level divided by 2, or 1 plus 0.99 divided by 2 equals 0.995. Next, we use the inverse normal function on our calculators with the standard normal distribution to find this z-score. We multiply this by the given population standard deviation 3, divide by the given margin of error 2. Finally, we square the whole thing to get approximately 14.9. This entire calculation is given in one line, as you see on the TI-84 screenshot. Recall that we always round the value n up to the next highest whole number. Do not round off, but round up. So we see that the minimum needed sample size is 15. If we know that the distribution of individual weights is normal, or nearly so, then we need a sample size of 15. If we do not know anything about the shape of the distribution of individuals, then we need a sample size larger than 30 to guarantee that the distribution of sample means is approximately normal. So in that case, we would have to increase the sample size to at least 31. In this example, weights are probably nearly normally distributed, so a sample size of 15 should suffice. Exercise 1, finding the needed sample size. Suppose that we are measuring the average salary of residents of Fort Smith, Arkansas. We want to produce a 90% confidence interval for the mean salary, and we want our margin of error to be no more than $20,000 per year. Furthermore, suppose that we know that the standard deviation of all salaries is $16,000 per year, and the distribution of sample means of salaries is distributed approximately normally. What is the minimum sample size needed for a study to produce this confidence interval? It is your turn to try one. After pressing pause, work this exercise out yourself. When you are satisfied with your answer, then press play and check your work against the next slide. Press pause now. Notice that we are given the population standard deviation, sigma sub x, equals $16,000, and we want a margin of error E of $2,000 or a bit below. We also desire a confidence level, 1 minus alpha, of 0.90. We see that the value of 1 minus alpha over 2 can be computed with adding 1 to the confidence level and then dividing by 2. Now we have identified all the numbers we need for the formula to compute the corresponding N. We substitute these values into the equation above and calculate as you see on the calculator screen. From this, we round up to the next whole number, so this rounds off to 174 for N. So we see that under these conditions, we need a sample size of at least 174.